So if you've ever wondered how Brockhampton manages to dress so well, or if maybe just like their style is reminiscent of something that you've seen before, then you have Nick Holiday, aka Nick Lanzini, to thank for the style that Brockhampton tends to promote really, really well. Welcome back, guys, to another video. In this video, I'm going to talk all about Nick Holiday, or Nick Lanzini. I'm going to refer to him as Nick Holiday. But yeah, in this video, I definitely wanted to cover him because he's kind of like an unofficial member of Brockhampton that you're going to see around like a lot. And not only that, but when we talk about Brockhampton and the creative side of, you know, what they revolve around, then usually they have a lot of people that they tend to like outsource to kind of get like ideas. So they have a couple photographers, videographers, and in this case, when it comes to styling and fashion, they definitely have Nick Holiday at their right hand. To go ahead and jump right into it, talk a little bit about his background. Nick Holiday was born on June 16th, 1995, and his hometown is St. Louis, Missouri. So growing up in St. Louis, Nick spent a lot of time in a store called Swedlife, which, if you guys don't know what it is pretty much like a fashion store that sells like exclusive t-shirts, clothing, and stuff like that. But it's also known for having like an in-house like Grand Theft Auto like session slash station. Sort of how like when you step inside of like a GameStop, they already have like consoles set up ready for you to like play whatever you want. From there, I think Nick took a lot of influence from hip-hop artists that kind of shaped his view on life and the direction that he wants to take in terms of fashion. So before, I would say like 2008, hip-hop fashion revolved a lot around like more of like the name brands, or maybe more of like high-end brands like Gucci and Louis and stuff like that. After that time period, it seems like streetwear and hip-hop just sort of like culture started to fuse and like mesh together a lot. One of the most relevant and like best examples of this is probably Odd Future's approach to their merch and kind of like reshaping the image of what merch looks like in the hip-hop world. From there, I would give Tyler, the Creator, a lot of credit for just shaping the Golf Wang brand, and then from there moving into like Golf LaFleur. But it's this kind of style that I think really influenced Nick's approach to how he wanted to envision his clothing. In many early interviews, Nick kind of talks about how Odd Future, Tyler, Creator, Swedlife, and just a lot of other hip-hop artists really influenced just his childhood growing up. So Nick, if you didn't know, like listens to a lot of hip hop. If you follow him on Instagram, then you'll see him posting stuff on his story all of the time, ranging from like old school hip hop to like modern day stuff. So besides being your average, you know, edgy skater teen, Nick really started to put his foot in the door in the fashion industry when he started his first brand, Stay Broke. Stay Broke essentially balanced a unique limited run pre-order concept that kind of had like a growing fan base of young fashion forward shoppers, and eventually it kind of just made t-shirts and just like skater fashion more affordable. Stay Broke usually had like an average price of like $20 to $25 per t-shirt, and all of them were made and hand-drawn and like hand-designed by Nick himself. In a lot of early interviews, Nick just kind of goes on to mention that he just wanted to make fashion, and not only that, but like cool, like modern fashion, more affordable for like the average person. In an interview, he states, "I started the pre-order concept because I'm drawing each tee by hand and didn't want to spend the time to draw a bunch of shirts without having advance orders. It turned out to be a cornerstone of the brand. People look out for the drops, which are available for a limited time only, from as little as 1 hour to as long as 1 week, and they know the need to snatch it up because it won't be released again." Stay Broke essentially pushed Nick and kind of gave him a little bit more context as to how well he can do in the fashion industry. The fact that he got started with this brand about 2 to 3 years ago really goes to show that he jumped in at a really, really good time where, you know, streetwear and hip-hop and just pop culture all started to really mesh and come together, especially through social media. From the Stay Broke brand, it was actually rebranded last year into Holiday brand. And Holiday brand probably rings more of a bell because you've more than likely seen Brockhampton members like sporting some Holiday merch. And the reason that there was a name change was simply because like once Nick kind of moved out of St. Louis, he actually moved to LA and kind of mentioned how that was a big move for him in the sense that he really had to push himself. At this point, fashion wasn't a hobby anymore. It really became his career, and he had to push himself to live in a new place where he knew that there were a lot more opportunities for him to kind of like grow his like fashionista eye. All in all, Holiday really just still sticks to Nick's vision of streetwear and kind of like the rare limited drops. If you ask me, Holiday brand seems to be heavily influenced by only New York, Supreme, and Off-White. The most founding model of what Holiday brand essentially looks like is that Nick will take other designs that have already been put out there and kind of just slap a hand-drawn like Holiday branding on top of it. If you ask me, like some of this stuff looks really good and I like kind of like the approach that you have to take. I know fashion doesn't always have to like essentially be something completely new and creative. Sometimes it could simply be just the restructuring of something that's already out there. The catch of doing this though is that Nick has faced a lot of criticism in the past for just slapping the Holiday brand on a lot of like designs that are already out there. A lot of people kind of think that he's just already stealing ideas that are out there and just slapping the Holiday brand so he can kind of put like a surcharge on it. And well, honestly, that's something for you guys to debate down in the comments. Just as many like designs that he's like rebranded with Holiday, he's also had like unique designs as well. At this point, you guys are probably wondering how Nick got involved with Brockhampton. Well, once he made the move to LA, Brockhampton really seeked out like more of like a creative team. It was working through Ashlyn Gray, one of their photographers, that they actually met Nick, and from there they started to, you know, ask him for some fashion advice for some of their music videos. And if you guys didn't know this already, Nick Holiday actually styled all of the clothing in the music video for Sweet, Junkie, Swamp, and Gummy by Brockhampton. He also kind of co-wrote / fashion directed all of Miserable America by Kevin Abstract, as well as Runner by Kevin Abstract. And if you guys are not familiar with it, Amir Van has a single called High Tolerance, and that was actually completely styled by Nick Holiday as well. So as you can see, like Nick immediately kind of got like a creative role in Brockhampton and just kind of helping them with their music videos. It was around this time last year that Nick also got the opportunity to co-write and style the music video for Spice Girl by Aminé. So Nick's vision for his fashion has brought him a lot of opportunities with working with Brockhampton. I think he also has a really big hand in kind of like helping Brockhampton style their merchandise as well. You can see Nick Holiday as a really good friend, but more than anything, just a big creative director and kind of like co-founder of what Brockhampton's image looks like today. This has been a quick little video about Nick Holiday, who he is, and what he kind of does for Brockhampton. Make sure to like and subscribe this video if you are new to the channel, and let me know down in the comments, have you ever purchased anything by Stay Broke or Holiday brand, and were you aware of Nick before he was even around Brockhampton? Thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I will definitely catch you guys in the next one.